Guys, I want to talk about the nature of the judiciary and the nature of justice. And I want to talk about the impartiality of judges and the basic concept of what a judge is or isn't. But let me give perspective to the whole thing by beginning my conversation with people we encounter in common life, in daily life. We don't usually encounter judges, right? Most of the time, we encounter people like taxi drivers, cooks, restaurateurs, shopkeepers, people like that, rickshawwalas. So let us just apply our mind to what we expect from a decent driver, a decent shopkeeper. What is the standard of decency in daily life? As I understand, suppose I'm traveling by auto rickshaw and I have some kind of a dispute with the rickshaw driver. Suppose I'm a bit rude to him, let us say. I have an argument with him on, say, politics. Let us say he thinks Modi is a fantastic guy and I think Modi isn't. So we have an argument. I don't expect the rickshaw driver to get angry with me and kick me off his rickshaw. I think he'll still get me to my destination, same as always. I don't expect the rickshaw driver to overcharge me either. He'll charge me the same, right? Now let us say I have an argument with a waiter. And let's say I'm rude to him. Let's say I'm a rude person. I still don't expect him to spit in my coffee. I expect him to serve me just as always, whether I have a dispute with him or not. Suppose I have hired a car driver to drive my car, and let us say I am a bad employer and I am rude to him. I wouldn't expect him to crash my car into a tree or run over a child or something, you know, just to get me into trouble. I expect him to do a decent job as a car driver, right? Now, the reason I ask all these questions is this. Why do we expect that if there's a judge and we are rude to a judge or we piss off a judge, or even just talk normally to a judge, why do we expect that a judge is not going to be judicious with your case? Why do we expect that he will spoil our case and give an adverse order? Isn't the one singular quality of a judge the quality of impartiality? Isn't it supposed to be impartial at all costs? Isn't he supposed to be impartial with you even if he's angry with you? Isn't he supposed to do justice to you, give you justice, even if he's terribly angry with you? Isn't he supposed to do that? I thought that is the point of justice. That's the point of impartiality. That is the point of being a judge. That is the quality that actually gets you to be a judge. Like, being able to drive well makes you a driver. Being able to fly well makes you a pilot. Being able to judge impartially without being temperamental, without losing your cool, without being dependent on how your litigant talks to you. I think that is what is supposed to be the distinguishing quality of a judge. But I am told, for some reason, I wonder why, that is the exact opposite of a judge's quality. And who tells me this? Who tells us this? The officers of the court, the lawyers. The lawyers tell us not to piss off the judge. The lawyers tell us to be very, very careful about what we say to a judge. The lawyers themselves seem to be speaking in a strange language, which seems to indicate that they address them like royalty, you know. They don't say Your Highness, or they don't say Your Majesty. They say Your Lordship, Lordship, Milord, Milord. I crave thee. I find it strange. They bow, they duck their head. They act as if the judge does them a huge favor every time he does something that is by due process. And the reason I ask this is, yes, I am now before the judiciary. I'm at a time of my life when there's a lot riding on the impartiality of judges. And I'm wondering, I'm seriously wondering, because of all the behaviors that advocates exhibit, what is the truth? Are judges impartial and just? Or are they, in the words of a friendly lawyer, are they temperamental geniuses? This friend said quite memorably that counsels treat judges as if they are temperamental geniuses. So you have to handle them with kid gloves. And if you are absolutely perfect in your handling of the judge, then he will deliver a fantastic order, but it's an order that will be favorable to you, I think. It's not about, I don't think the behavior of counsels reflects that they believe that the judge is going to be impartial. I think it reflects that they believe that the judge will rule in their favor. So the more they duck their head, the more they say milord and I crave leave and, you know, all those slavish sounding words. I can't even come up with those words. Counsel seem to think that is the way to get what they want. Not justice. Not impartiality. That is the way to get what they want. That is the way to get an order, a favorable order, or a favorable judgment.
Congratulations.
Oh, I am bothered by this. I am really bothered by this as a citizen. Okay. I have been taught that everybody must do the right thing, regardless of relationships. I have been taught that I have to speak without fear or favor. And now I am being taught in court that everybody will speak without fear or favor except judges, who will speak with favor or something like that, but in any case will not speak without fear or favor, will not speak impartially. This is the strongest message that I get from lawyers around me. And lawyers should know, they are officers of the court. They are before various judges day in and day out. They meet judges all the time. They interact with judges all the time. So they should know, right? Someone has to solve this mystery. I know I'm going to rub a lot of people the wrong way, judges especially, and some counsel is going to try to get a judge to haul me up for contempt. But I seriously want the judges, whoever is listening, to answer this question. Is he impartial or not? Is he just or not? Is he just enough to do justice with someone he doesn't like? Is he just enough to do justice with someone who pisses him off, who gets him angry? Is he just enough with a common man who will not bow before him? You know, there's this song we sing and we seem to be very proud of it. You know, what is it? Sar kata sakte hain, lekin sar jhuka sakte nahi. We sing this every Independence Day and every Republic Day. Sar kata sakte hain, lekin sar jhuka sakte nahi. Is it only for the soldiers on our border? Only the soldiers on our border are going to say sar kata sakte hain lekin sar jhuka sakte nahi? Under what circumstances will a common man say these words? And if a common man says these words to a judge, what will the judge do? I'm curious. I'm very, very curious to know how things will go.